It's the mindset. Free your mind, mindset. Free your mind. Hey, not everything that glitter is gold. Everything that's white is snow. On the mindset, I just don't let them know, let them know, let them know. Oh, words from the wise, I just star, he will never lie. Stand tall, he will never die, will forever shine. I just star, shine like the star in the sky. Some hate, some love.
That is not the point. We were taught not to tell lie. Speak the truth and speak it ever, cause it what it will. He who hide the wrong, he does. Do the wrong till still. The world I will tell lie. But when a system, individuals lie, but when a system perpetuate a lie, that system is of no importance or significance to the movement, the development and the spiritual awakening of the people. We have to understand that. We have to understand, say, when I want to say it's Christmas time, no, we have to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. But you know, say, most of the people, them, not celebrating the birth of Jesus. They may go to church one at a time, and that is that. But them go to church right through the year anyway. Them go to church right, it is more important to get a new fridge, a new stove, a new TV, some eyelash, some whatsoever they want to wear, some panty, denim panty, or something, some Clark shoes or something. It is more important in the minds of the people them to get money. What do I say? The idea is to get money. There's more money circulating in this time because the capitalists them allow you to spend. You see, you tell you say them have a much $1 billion in circulation that people can have a wonderful Christmas, even though they must suffer more now, especially through the COVID. There's more suffering now through the COVID. More psychological imbalance minds are run up and down about the place and now through the COVID. But them get your faith, ease up now and say, you want some money. So the thief them is on the rampart right now. More thief. The thief them come out in full force. The people them who used to sell certain things, them know so well the things that them never used to sell during the year, they are going to bring it out in front of you now and put it up front in the glass case that them can't get you right quick because they might say they are going to put discount on that. Therefore now, only you can want it. And even though all you got on the money, because really and truly, them not think on January and February, because maybe them don't have to think on it again because school kind of look like it ease up here now. What is it? What is it that is causing us to sidestep and move and go like say the reality? Not going to eat with somewhere down the line, it's going to eat you. It's going to jolt you out of the nightmare, out of the illusion. Because that is really what it is. We were sold an illusion for hundreds of years, and we continue the illusion. And the illusion is not helping us. It is not, especially black people, me I talk about, because it helps white people, because white people have the economy and the things them that going to make black people buy out what them do have. All the while, they don't have a 20-inch, 30-inch, 40-inch TV. You're going to pressure somebody now to get that TV. Because it's Christmas now. All the shoes where they look under the glass case the whole year. You can go get the shoes now. All the little things that the youth did want for play with the new phone, the new this, the new that. You can go get it now. Because you can go make sure, say, by any means necessary, you can go build up an economy in your thinking for getting that thing. But when I hear nothing more about Jesus, nothing in Jesus, warm to the pastor them, who no shame. Who no shame. I talk about the pastor them. The whole year, who not celebrate Jesus Christ Christmas. And when the birthday come, who not have the people them run up and down in all the mall them, all the mall them. When you look on all up at Redhills Road and when them call it, the place up there, so I make a mart and all them places. It cock like what? Cock, 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 cock. Black people are spend like spend. Spend where them not have. And where them not have, them spend it too. And them go borrow money to spend. And the credit card them just a flow, so just a flow, so just a flow. NCB credit card, Jane and credit card, Sajic Work credit card. The card them just a flow, so poor people are use credit card. Poor people. You might wonder, oh, poor people can have credit card. Yes. You think them easy? You think them easy? Nobody now walk with cash again. Most of them are some girl where you see upon the road. Them now walk with no cash. Even though them know, it's like a man who have him go buy a Chris Mercedes Benz, and him now have no yard for parking it now. Him now have no yard for park the Benz. The BMW, him now have no yard for parking it now. Well, I see him with them people, poor people, black people, have them credit card. And I know them are going to use it. Know them are going to use it. I see when the next year come now, they have to go pay back the money, but them now realize that is the capitalist way, the capitalist system. You know, see, people get rid of cash now. People get rid of cash. I'm sorry for the man that went up on the roadside, I beg, you know, you have to go get a cash machine, a NCB automated machine, if you get money out of it. But warm to Jesus. Warm to Jesus. How much people in Jamaica know what Boxing Day mean? Because you have a holiday named Boxing Day, and the day after Christmas named Boxing Day, 26th of December. How much youth in Jamaica, if you ask him tomorrow morning, tell me something, you know, say you have a holiday named Boxing Day. He might say, you have a holiday named Boxing Day? He say, yes. Where Boxing Day is? What is the purpose of Boxing Day? I guarantee you, all the big people, them, all the millennials, all the millennials don't know what Boxing Day represent in our British history. In our colonial history, a whole heap of we don't know where Boxing Day is, what it mean. Because a man could have said in the Bible, through the near Christmas, me say, oh, Boxing Day, that must be in the Bible, you know. Boxing Day, no, no Bible. Christmas, no, no Bible, neither. That's the problem with that. Christmas, not in the Bible. But guess what? Me, start sit down, so now I'm going to make no difference. But it's true, me can't talk, and me have a conscience and a consciousness, we say, if the watchman sees the danger and don't warn the people, and no matter how long you warn, till you could have to say you warn them, no one not happen. But as me say, when we just start out, I would tell people, say, no man named Jesus born on the 25th of December. People used to mock and jeer the program, call radio station and tell them, say, take off that damn idiot boy off of the radio. What mean Jesus not born on Christmas? Eh? The whole world are celebrate Christmas and him they attack damn foolishness. But yet still we didn't know. See, a whole people not celebrate the 25th of December. We know that. You have Christian people in Jamaica who don't celebrate the 25th of December. We know that too. But the majority of people celebrate the 25th of December. But them don't know why they must celebrate it. A whole people now don't even know why they must celebrate them say. Well, them say Jesus born. All the symbols of Christmas. If you ask a normal Jamaican, why you have a Christmas tree? Why you deck the halls and all them something there? What is it that you're celebrating when you do these things? Why you have Santa Claus? Which part of Santa Claus come from? Santa Claus come from down the road. Santa Claus come from down the road. One of the store them, find one man and dress him up that way there to sell them goods. Santa Claus. When me a youth, we go down King Street, because King Street, just like how you have now, we could have likened to King Street. But I'm never seen a street in Kingston you were likened to King Street to rotted. Because King Street was the whole of King Street from up at Parish Church, go right down to Victoria Pier. Store upon top of store upon top of store. Well, you'll have a store named Time Store. Time Store was the main store during Christmas because them used to have Santa Claus sitting in there. Ho, 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 ho. Sitting in there. And the people them could sit down in their lap. And them present and gift wrap and all them something. And the children them love it. Because that is where them parents them bring them up in a Santa Claus. Look on King Street today. Look on King Street today. Where Time Store there? No Time Store no longer again. Nathan's not down there again. Easter's not down there again. I mean, none of them things are not down there again. It's like it almost get desolate. But who know the original Santa Claus? I mean, I might know it, but most Jamaican people don't know it. Them just a father like large sheep. It grieves my heart for no say. We're supposed to be thinking and having a clear consciousness, and we make them move way either and thither, and not knowing where we are going. And people say it affect we home. This Christmas thing affect we home, especially now with poor people. Poor people get affected right now because of Christmas. Because you have to go find money where you never usually have. And you could all take the rent money and buy things. And remember, say you have to go pay the rent and the light bill and the water rate and all them things there. Instead of you make sure, say, this is for the water rate, this is for the light bill, this is for the rent and all them something there. You just spend that. Because you see at Christmas. At one time you have Christmas a year, so you have to just make use of it. And we just spend that. And then January, February come, now you start to vex and feel away and angle the picnic rough. You angle the picnic rough and you spend, sometimes the picnic never ask you for nothing, you know. And you see at Christmas, you know, when the picnic feel away. And I really and truly the picnic feel away. Because you make the picnic feel away. Because when him come amongst him friend, him and him friend, or her friend, have a little thing, and him say him not have it, him get vicious. Yeah, him say, oh, come him not have that. And when him go home and say, mama, I come and say, I don't have no money for buy it. But yet still him see you go buy denim drawers and eyelash and all sort of aisle shoes that you can't walk in. And all sort of things him see you buy for yourself, for God, during the holiday. So that, when him look at all that, him think a different way too. So when I tell you, say, even though people might have said, well, Christmas is a time of giving and meeting family and everything. Yeah. That is a certain kind of people. You have the majority of people who don't have that happening for them. Them don't have that happening for them. You know, see it? So what can we do? We have to get our mind together. Our mind have to get together. And me not going to tell a man to celebrate Christmas, you know, because me not celebrate Christmas. No guy, nobody can come. I mean, real and truly, me not celebrate Christmas. I mean, the wrong's no one where me really believe say I go celebrate Christmas to the point where boy, they go pressure me to buy things and my children. They go pressure me to buy things because of Christmas and all them something there. But we have to think. After all of what we have got through during the year, yes or no, and last year, we are going to put Christmas on the map, put Christmas on the psyche, on the thinking, in order to feel better about yourself. Because there's a whole heap of way you can feel better about yourself, you know. That's just a specific day where you're still, you're not interested in that anyway. Because most of them girls will buy them wig and them eyelash and them something there. They have no business about Jesus. Most of them youth, you say, I walk up and down with bleached face and wang, this and what, that, and, you know, have the Clark's booty and the tight up pants, so itch up and eat them and all them something. Them no business about no Jesus. But at Christmas, and them business about Christmas, them say a holiday. a holiday and they have to get something new. You know see it? They have to get something new for go show yourself why, yeah, oh, me just buy this and on. If it's even a cell phone, they have to thief. Because now the cell, hey, you better hold on upon the cell phone, them, you know. Hold on upon the cell phone. Me tell you, me sit down in a car till my lady come to the car and say, see that man there. A man show him on, you know. And then, you know, joke business, you know. The man come to her and say, boy, right now, some man chop off a man and take him cell phone. I like the man them tell her, the man have a one hand. And the man say, chop off a man and take him cell phone. And you see, this time of year, you know, cell phone is one of the gift them. The first gift that people give themselves. Especially them boy around up and down on the road. A man will shoot you for your cell phone. Imagine that. A man will shoot you for your cell phone. You know what I'm saying? A man will stab you for your cell phone. A man will chop off your hand for your cell phone. Like yesterday when a man showed me his hand. I see my hand. My wife see my hand and I explain to my wife. Say, if somebody chop off him hand and take away his cell phone. What a terrible thing. And then you go see them are walking at the mall. You know, identify them, you know, but you know. It's worse now, you know, not them have a mask, you know. Yes, it's worse now that everybody have a mask, so you can't identify nobody. And them is prowling through the malls and supermarkets and shopping centers and all these places. And you have some data out there, you know, will love show off to them have certain phone. Yeah, but you have some daughters out there, boy, why them have to show off to them have this phone and this iPhone 910 and iPhone ZZZZZ and LBGTQRSTLFMNOP and all these things. They have to feel good about it. And them want people to see it, say them have this. That is the thing now, you know. Them have a cell phone, and say them keep the cell phone to themselves. Them want the world know, say them have it. So the man at the bus and I show it off, hold it in the, so they're not talking to nobody, they're going to hold it in their ears. So I walk on the road and I hold up the phone and I say, yes, sir, how are you saying? And I have something. Brand new cell phone. And the man, I watch them. You to watch them. And just grab that and run gone. And I know them buy a cell phone, you know. It's a man, them pressure for buy the cell phone for them. Imagine that. So, where the message is? The message is, don't make the capitalists them pressure on no. That is the message we are talking about. That is the crux of the matter. Don't make the capitalists them pressure on no. Because that is what them they have to do. Them they have to pressure you. And then, in your ignorance, you feel say you are being blessed. But ignorance is not bliss. Ignorance is not bliss. Ignorance sometimes is stupidity. And sometimes people make the wrong decision and wrong move. And no care what you tell them. Them no care what you want to say until late down the line. Way down the line, just like what me tell you, say, them used to cuss the program through me and tell you Jesus no born for the 25 December. People cuss until them stop cuss because it open up now and them start to realize, say, yes. A true mortal talk, you know, Jesus not born on the 25 December. And everybody start to show you this a star and sun and this and all these things they must show you. You know, see? So we have to take charge ourselves. I mean, I tell the people, this is my message, you know. You have to take charge of yourself, take charge of your children, them, and know exactly how far you can go as it relates to present, as it relates to your movement. As it relates to your doing and your family and your house, you can't make people come pressure you to buy what you can't afford and go make man do something to you, forget something, for go pay for this and that and that way. He might look something for you because he might look whatsoever might look for you. And you have to take the money for go do this and do that. Don't sell yourself that way there. Yeah, man, me hear you talk. Say, why? Muta can't go and talk. You know, see, Muta can't go and talk because me see address me well want uptown, you see. I don't care what me go get it. Wow. This is the message. This is the message. The message is, don't make nobody force you into doing things or you don't want to do for something where it's not lasting and eternal. Because after the storm, the calm going to bring sorrow. It's going to bring sorrow. Not only for you, but for your child or your children. Because remember, you know, all them things away you buy, you know. It's when Christmas done, sometimes a whole heap of people don't use the things them, you know. Yeah, man, sometimes you buy something during Christmas. When Christmas done, you know, but I use it. You put it up and I wait for the next Christmas. And by the next Christmas come, you want something else, you know, but I deal with that one day. It's like cell phone. It's like cell phone and young people. That's how iPhone get for trick the people, them. Them bring out a phone, brand new phone with a certain feature. And then, no. Copious time, them say, all right, watch out for this feature upon this phone, yeah. This feature is a different feature, and everybody are wait for the feature, or wait for the phone. Yeah, people go stand up in a line and wait to get the first cell iPhone, them will have a certain feature. And young people stay that way there. And young people will pressure them parents' feet. And if your parents can't afford it, then go and go out there, go get it by any means necessary because of them peers, peer pressure. Me see you with a phone there, me can't afford it, but me want it, and by any means necessary, me go get it. It's like how Christmas are come, me know how to get it. And nothing at the church, or maybe you can't go to the church, go get it too. Because some of them pass, you know, will help you get it too. Some of them pass will help you get it. This is the cutting edge, and I refrain with they are with you. Ye too, where we are saying, you know, we're not just babbling, you know. We're not just babbling. We sincerely mean what we are saying. Where is Jesus in all of this? Where is Jesus? I wonder if him can't afford to come because him never take the vaccine. But I'm going to find a way to bring him. Cutting edge.